We can also encode data into our visualization using color. We can typically encode values with color in two different ways: hue and saturation. They can be used individually or in combination. Color hue is what we typically refer to as color, like red or green or blue. Different colors used together usually indicate categorical data, where each color represents a different group. So if we were using our baseball data, maybe green is shortstops, red is outfielders, and orange is second baseman, something like that. Saturation is the intensity of color for a given hue. So if your selected color was blue, high saturation would be very blue, and the color would look faded as you decrease your saturation. We usually use saturation to encode intensity or quantity of a value. So maybe if we were encoding number of home runs with saturation, more home runs would be darker and fewer home runs would be lighter. Or if we were encoding odd har enrollments, more enrollments would be darker and fewer enrollments would be lighter. We could also use hue and saturation in combination. So you can see here that no hue and no saturation is set to zero. And in this particular encoding, the more saturated our purple-like color is, the more negative we are. And the more saturated our green-like color is, the more positive we are. This might accentuate the differences in value and tell us when the value is positive or negative and how intense the absolute value of that effect is. When using color to encode information, a pretty good general rule of thumb is that you shouldn't use more than a dozen colors to encode categories effectively. If you were to use more than 12 colors, it might be hard to quickly differentiate between categories, and your visualization is going to become a little bit harder to parse.